So here we are going to discuss the concept of strings and sorting. Sorting is arranging all the characters in a particular order. The order can be ascending order, it can be descending order. So we use different methods, various methods in C language for sorting data. Selection sort, a bubble sort, quick sort, insertion sort and med sort and etc. So this program is to sort the characters in one string, sorting letters in one particular string. So you take a string is group of characters. Look at the program, use necessary header files. So what is a string variable here? String, you can use a different variable name. So in this program we initialize the string. A string can be initialized in two ways. One, you can put the string within double quotations, or you can put the each and every character in a string in single quotations and must end with backslash zero. Backslash zero is treated as a null character. So string initialization can be done in two ways, and here the string is initialized. You want to read the string, you can read the string either using scanf with % notation, or you can use getS. So here we are trying to arrange all the letters in one particular string in an order. So we used strlen to find the length of the string, and we use the concept. Look at this program. Check it out. Is this a selection sort? I think it's a selection sort. So we have two for loops. I is equal to 0, I less than n minus 1 and I plus plus. And j is equal to I plus 1, j less than and j plus plus. When I is 0, j starts with 1. So string of I greater than string of 0. String of I, your first letter, string of 0 is your first character, is greater than string of j, the second character, then we need to swap them. So those who are having any problem with sorting techniques, please refer either selection sort video or bubble sort video. So we need to swap. Temp is equal to a of I is equal to a of j, and a of j is equal to temp. I use the term a here, not string. So while working with the program, you can make a change, use a convenient variable name. And after sorting, you use a printf statement to print the string. So I repeat, this program is to sort characters in one particular string. And look at this program. This program is to sort a certain number of input strings. You take some strings, 5 or 6 strings, and you try to sort them. In the previous program, you take one string and sort the letters in that particular string. And in this program, we are taking more than one string and we are trying to sort the strings. Look at the declaration clearly. What is this variable here, str? Look at the two-dimensional declaration, str of 25 and 25. As I told you earlier, that square brackets, we use the term subscript. In case of one dimension, we use one subscript. In case of two dimension, we use two subscripts. So why do we need this? Yeah, we have array of strings here, array of strings. And for that we need two dimension. So look at that putS, how many strings you want to enter, count. So if your count is 2, mean your input is 2, you need to enter 2 strings and enter the strings one by one. We used getS to read the data. Look at that for loop. When I is 0, str of 0, str of 0 means you are reading the first string. When I is 1, str of 1, second string. When I is 2, str of 2, third string. So we are reading an array of strings. to read a string we use getS here, and as usual we have to use any one of the methods, either selection sort or bubble sort. To sort the strings we cannot simply use an if statement. To compare any two strings we need to use strcmp, string comparison. Here we are sorting array of strings, so one string is to be compared with other string. When I is 0, strcmp of str 0 comma str 1 greater than 0. Str 0 is first string, str 1 is second string. So first string compared with the second string, if it is greater than 0 we need to swap. For swapping also we cannot use a regular notation. In case of string we need to use strcpy, string copy. You cannot simply write temp is equal to str of I. We need to use strcpy to copy one string to another string. So after sorting we need to display all the sorted strings, and for that we need use for loop again. When I is 0, put as str of 0 first string, when I is 1 second string, when I is 2 and third string, and so on. So execute this program and give some input like SAI, IAS and AIS. You give any three strings like that and check out the output. And check out each and every character of the strings and how it is sorted.